real quick because I have a lot of school stuff and just stuff to do, and I wanted to get reading done today to kind of not fall into a slump after Booktubeathon. But I'm going to do a Top 5 Wednesday video. I used to do them for a lot. I did quite a few of them, and then I didn't do them for a while because I guess the topics, either I didn't have enough books with me because my books are in storage, or they just didn't appeal to me enough to motivate me to do a video. But I thought this one sounded cool, and it sounded like something that could be done quickly and easily. So yeah, it's top 5 book covers you'd like to live in. And yeah, let's just get started. Descending from number 5 to number 1. So number 5, I have Aristotle and Dante Discover the Secrets of the Universe with Benjamin O'Leary Sainz. It's still really long every time. But yes, this cover is gorgeous, and I liked the whole aesthetic and setting of just being outside at night, in kind of a deserted farm-like area with a truck looking at the stars and kind of a nice breeze. And it seemed cool and cute. And so yeah, that's number 5. Number 4, I have The Darkest Part of the Forest by Holly Black. Just magical forest with fairies, and sure, fairies are usually evil, but I love this book so much, and just the kind of magical forest element of having creatures and stuff in the forest, I've always been into. Now, this was the only one on this list that I haven't read, but I have An Ember in the Ashes by Saba Tahir. I think this book is gorgeous, and I have been reading the desert set books. I've been watching the novella José de Egipto. I've been playing Far Cry 4, which kind of has a culture-y setting. But yeah, I've been into a lot of deserty things lately, and so I think this cover is just gorgeous. And sure, as someone who hates the heat, the desert is a strange place for me to choose, but lately I've been really liking the aesthetic of it, so that's number 3. Then number 2, I have The Isle of the Lost by Melissa De La Cruz. Obviously not this, because that's not a place, but the back I think is gorgeous, and it's something that they keep kind of coming back to within the series, and just whether it be in the place where they have their trials, or in Auradon, or anything in this world. I mean, sure, the Isle is kind of a terrible place to live, but Auradon-ish, I would love to live there, and it's just so gorgeous. So that's number 2, and number 1, because I'm me, I have City of Bones by Cassandra Clare, and it's, it has New York, and I am from New York originally. I was born there, and I lived there until I was about 7, and then we left, and I have always wanted to live there, again ever since. And then on the bottom, if you, focus in, there's, kind of, a different, a dark city underneath, kind of, it reminds me of the movie cover that has the half and half of, the Shadowhunter world and then, New York, so being exposed to both or either, or I love New York, I love this world, so yes. And that's about it. So if you like this video, be sure to give a thumbs up, and please subscribe if you'd like to see more of my face and my voice.